You need to get your affairs in order, man. These men are not sharp. What the hell have you been doing? I see you've been working on your strength. It's 56, which is brilliant. Let's see. Is there any way to get a shot in on that guy? Wow, that was good. That's deserving of compliments. I mean, I've been bitching on you guys a little bit here, but that was good. Also, the landing spot for the Sky Ranger deserves a little praise. It's not all bad. But holy shit, that potato aim. Mr. Alcatraz, welcome. Welcome to the stream. So we got lucky. It looks like we got lucky. And this thing is intact. And since there's a bit of an Illyrian crisis at Africa base, I very much welcome any bonus we can get. That was pretty good. Aggressive scouting. I'm impressed. Did you get your second kill? Yes, you do. That was pretty good. We're gonna check the stats on Jace Tank after this, because he's been racking up kills like crazy ever since he got 10 kills in 2 missions. And he did that smiling contest with the chrysalid. I probably just jinxed him, because I said I liked him. This is usually the end of a soldier really quickly. 10th Legion! That aim, it's beautiful. Because on average, you're on cue. You became unconscious and died from a fatal wound. I was hopeful there for a second. The 10th Legion can just take him out, I think. That potato aim is just... it's horrible. Horst, show how it's done, man. Just shoot him in the face. Wow, you did. That was not bad. It seemed better, but it's not bad. Oh, Lyra, can you make this angle work? It's a bit tricky, I thought. Horst can't sidestep anymore, though. Yeah, we lost one. Very unfortunate. But 50 Illyrium makes it up for it, definitely. We'll immediately take care of business. And have a new guy in there. Who died? Actually, who needs a soldier? I mean, it's first come, first serve. That's what's happened when you get too popular, yeah. Well, Mr. Stank, you still have 10 kills only after 6 missions. I thought you had some more after that mission, but might have been the other one on the other base. You have improved quite a bit. There's some real gems in there. Look at Malkuth. He's seen so much men being slaughtered throughout his career that he's toughened up. He's become insensitive to death around him. Oh, need one. Ruza needs one. There you go. Well, you wanted one with aim. You got one with everything. Bravery 60. Firing accuracy 61. And a psionic strength of 54. Makes you pretty damn awesome. You'll be the new face tank, though. But that's the burden of being in. Maybe I should rearrange it a little bit at some rank. Because 5 Ace has been doing well. Actually, no, you have your second guy. Alira's been doing well. You would deserve some way lean back time. Lonestone, I think since you just came in and you're a rookie, should be more at the front. 10th Legion is pretty much where he needs to be. I'll put you a little bit more forward. Kalajit is doing well, can see some more action. Let's Super Duca move up a bit. Okay. Good to go. And there's another mission coming up. This is Large Card with Snakeman. And it's a rather simple cleanup, but you never know in these circumstances. There you go, there's another building straight to our left, and a UFO, and a building behind us. We are all pretty much screwed, and you know it. Now we finally see it. And it doesn't even necessarily have to be the one that shot at us. And another building. Oh, God. Why, game, why? Well, Alcatrazzles. You're immediately going to see some pretty nasty action. Maybe it's actually safer for you to be inside the building, or at least hug the wall and look left or something. Let's take care of this guy, because he's annoying. No line of fire. Oh, yeah. Wings of planes and stuff. Nice! That was a good shot. Might have been just one guy looking at us from over there. Why is he not dying? Finally! Yeah, you should play that song while I play this game, Malkuth. It's the end of the world as we know it. The game seems to be particularly hateful of us tonight, with all the bloody buildings and crap that's going on. I mean, we've been pulling it off. It's not like it's absolutely horrible like the first two sessions of this playthrough. But it's throwing us a lot of curveballs tonight. Yeah, this is the most horrible landing zone ever, Horst. Great LZ. Glad you put the flare down. We've been past that point, right? Elduk Arena and Klaziranen are gonna close it out. We got shot, I have no idea from where. Oh, they're coming out of the walls, man! Skeeto, fire in the hole! You know there's gonna be one here. Excellent, this is great, because you can just shoot through the wall. Thank you. I actually got hurt, a little bit. You're not bleeding though. Ooh, you see one. Nice. Good shot, Lonestone. Finally, I think that's your first kill of the day, sir, and it's an important one. Trying to keep eyes on the rooftops of the buildings. Not easy to do. We also need to approach the UFO and other stuff like that. No doubt there's still aliens on the rooftop of this building, or on the second floor. Actually, Lonestone, you can make a little opening here. No, you can't. Alright. Yeah, let's just keep an eye on the rooftops here and make sure that some people can still react and crap like that. Not liking it at all, but so far, you know, we're pulling it off. Somewhat. Where? There it is. That might be a cookie for Mr. Alchemist here. We can just shoot through everything. One more. And then it started firing back. No angle? Make an angle. That was pretty good. No line of fire. You have 49 time units and one grenade. If I prime it. Altogether this is 45, so no dice. Wait. And get reinforcements. Okay, this looks somewhat clean. Which is good. We got eyes on this rooftop, which is fine as well. We should get to this building as well. There you go. Ruza, that is some brilliant scouting, my friend. That is awesome. Take care of that one. And Comrade here can take care of the other one. Hopefully, without shooting Ruza in the back. Nicely done. I suspect the rest is in the UFO, but you can never be too careful. Now, okay, Ruza, you're pretty safe down there. You're probably going to survive the mission. Now, let's get some reinforcements here. No, damn it, that's a misclick. Alright, you can get back in later. It's almost as if this isn't a Battle Bunny Let's Play. Why, there's not enough carnage going on. Sorry, man. I've been playing this game a lot, though. Maybe it's been helping, but... Yeah, you guys are also just kicking ass. You're doing the proper things. You're hitting them when you should. Skeeto. That is true. There's been no friendly fire. That was an interesting exchange. Scruffy came out unscathed. You should probably back off. That's a stun launcher. We laugh at those. Step closer. I am Mufatu! Good of you to join us, man. You missed the last one, I believe. I've kind of parked your soldier out in the base, not using it. But it's gonna see some action from now on. Welcome. And this is clean as it can be. Wow. It's also Illyrium for Base Africa, which is even better. Ooh. Wow-a-wee. This thing will land. It's gonna be landing in darkness, but it will land. I'm gonna give it an escort in a sec. 13 soldiers, so one kicked the bucket. Sorry, one is wounded. You don't fly back home when you're wounded, apparently. You just... you're not on the Sky Ranger, so... you get put on an ordinary plane. You can't fly back with the squad. Which is very mean. Alrighty. I think we found a Mufatu for Africa, then. Since you just came in, so... There's another one here? No. And as good Mufatu clones go, this one is pretty damn horrible. Keeping that tradition alive. Well, actually, your firing accuracy is very decent. You just don't have a lot of psionic strength, so that goes for everybody here. We already did some selecting, Mufatu. We got all the Psy soldiers down here. Kind of waiting on the psionic labs to be done. And then those guys can start training. Ah, this thing already landed. That's a bit too fast for my comfort. However, these things will land twice. Trust me. They will land twice. Come on. Land again. Actually, wait a little bit. Wait until the Sky Ranger is there. Night mission, guys. You all love it. It's the Age of Flares again. The first four are gonna get them in hand. Actually, the first six are gonna get them in hand. Because the first two might just die without actually chucking it. There we go. Hi, Klazirinen. 4:55 a.m. for you. Are you quite the trooper? 40 minutes for you. Why? You gotta head out to bed, or are you going to work? I hope we'll make it worth it, Klazirinen. I probably should just start by chucking one of these out and oh wait, this is the edge of the map. Guys, there's no escaping it. Wow, okay. You survived. You survived that too. That's impressive. Once again, we park ourselves right next to a bunch of bloody buildings in the middle of the bloody night. What is up tonight? We've been getting away with that crap too. We should put these flares on top of these buildings, I suppose. Ah, that worked. But because of these stupid buildings in our way, we can't chuck the flares really where I want them. Out of range. I suppose there's nothing else we can do, really, just except move. And possibly get some flares in like this and get some weird angles going. Mr. O'Leara. Oh, no! Hey, a wild Captain K appears. I didn't really see where that shot came from because I was watching the chat and Captain K kind of distracted me. So, if people die, it's his fault. We don't have enough time units with O'Leara. We might have with Kalaja, so we'll just chuck this thing up on the roof with him. And hopefully not get shot. I'm not liking this position at all to start off on. Not one bit. Not one bit. To compensate for that, I'm gonna unload every single guy that we have. No line of fire, really? Why not? Is there somebody in your way? No, there's not. Just make a line of fire then. And step aside. Let others benefit from your mindless aggression. There's another alien to its right. So there's more mindless aggression being needed here. Alchemist, you're up. Stop shooting! Jesus. Ducky. Do it! Alright. You still get your kills in sometimes, which is cool. I mean, it's not like I'm playing very risky with you, but at the same time, you are seeing some action. We're gonna try and make it work with you. Oh, crap. I say this, and we find one in the middle of the frickin' roof. Ducky, step away. Malkuth. Is there any way you can take a shot? No, there's not. Because there's people in the way. Alright, this alien up here is gonna have a ball, guys. He's gonna have some fun. Yeah, they can't use grenades in the first turn, which is very lucky. But he still might just start hammering down. Might actually kill the commander, you never know. At the very least, he'll inform his friends of where we are. Horse got murdered. And Lonsdon got murdered. wanted the important kills, Ducky. This is one. At the same time, there's one on the roof here. That also is very much in need of dying. We can't see him, apparently, for some reason. Why not? Why can't we see him? Because he's over here. Step aside. Good kill. I do think there's still one on the roof, though. And I suppose the easiest way to get rid of him is to chuck a grenade up there. But we need to do it with somebody who's not under the wing of a plane. And you can actually make that angle work, and you don't have to be carrying a flare either. That might have done it. At least if he survived, he fell down. Ducky, stay put. We don't have more flares, so I'm going to be very careful. We need the guys with the flares to push up a bit and throw them around corners and stuff like that. These buildings, man. These bloody buildings. Wow, we see two now. Both are high up in the air. I think he's still alive, there's no biggie though. Did you just shoot your commander? No. So there's the death penalty on that. Alright, nice! Well, the flares are running out, but we can pick them up from the ground and throw them again. And of course, Super Ilu, who's from the cult of the flare, will never give up his. Alright, that's it for this round. I don't know why floaters would fall down. Apparently, if they died, you know, the whole mechanism shuts down. That's not what I wanted. I wanted you to shoot the hedge. So then next time you can actually move through it. Oh wait, you had a... Okay, well we can chuck two with you then. If you survived a round, you're gonna get help. There we go. Mr. Ducky, choose the safe route for now, but we definitely need you to move up and inspire confidence. Mr. Rusa, pick it up and throw it again. Not enough time units. Okay, the next turn you throw it again. For the record, guys, this is a harvester. This thing has lots of aliens. And we haven't seen the UFO even, so I'm not too pleased yet. Mr. O'Leary, you do have to part with your flare now, I'm afraid. Thank you. I know that was hard to do for you. But sacrifices need to be made. Let's go through the building. Alright, that's good. We spotted two over there, I think. More buildings. That calls for grenades. Mr. Malkuth, you have plenty of grenades. Actually, we just... Let's kill this building. Entirely. Of course, the smoke is not going to help us. I was kind of expecting us to find him now. Oh, we do. That's the UFO right there, guys. You can see it now. This sharp outline there. There it is. We have found it. But O'Leary did have a point. We're kind of short on flare, so we need to get through this quick. I'm pretty sure once we start whacking aliens in the UFO, they'll start panicking. Which is kind of where we need to be. We need this flare to move up. There you go. We have another one. That's pretty good. Yeah, that's a useful flare. Malkuth can't take the shot anymore. This might be a kill for Ducky. 42 for an aimed shot. And I'm still not happy with how your aim works out in practice. On paper, all good. But in practice, eh. Nice! Alchemist, holy shit. All three shots would have hit him. If there was not a wall in between there. For an accuracy of 44, that's really just ignoring what the paper says. That's impressive stuff. Rusa... out of range. You need to work out in the gym, my friend. You're a bit weak. You need more strength in those upper body parts. If you can't chuck that far... You really have no business being on a night mission, really. Approaching our objective. Yeah, there's no such thing as an innocent building. All buildings are evil to the core. By default. And there might be situations, you know, where there are exceptions, but they're very rare. Too rare to really take into account. All buildings must die. Let's blow this one up entirely so we can just move through it. Alright, Super Lou just laughs at explosions going off next to his right ear. Oh, you still have a flare. It's quite handy. That's a good throw. There are two entrances to this UFO. One is down here and one is all the way on the other side. So the guys up here are going to play a big role. You guys are going to be the guys entering the UFO. And of course our brave commanding officers here, El Docorino and Malkuth himself, will also need to move up. Hi, Mr. Sothrus. Good to see you on the stream, man. Finland is well represented tonight. Sol, welcome back. Haven't seen you since the first stream. I have no idea if your soldier is... Yeah, your soldier is still alive. He was good at psionic strength. And so he was selected for training. Which means he doesn't go out on missions. At least that's the one in base Europe. I don't know if you had a soldier at some point in base Africa. I don't think you did. I don't think we got that far with you watching. Yeah, you're not dead. Your guy is alive and kicking and he's being put into nasty stasis tanks and his head is being probed with electrodes. And you're not dead, but you're not having a good time either. Mr. Stank, that was quite horrible. Rusa, do the grenade thing. Oh yeah. You had weak upper body strength. You're gonna carry a live grenade around for a bit. Oh, come on, you guys are all weaklings. You can't even chuck a grenade over here. Kilad, you got 35 strength. Nice. We did blow up our flare. And we also have people walking around now with live grenades in their hands, which is something we need to take into account. Yeah, that's true as well, Sol. You survived two base attacks where your soldier was called into action. Usually I don't use soldiers that are not watching the stream. Or I put them at the front of the Sky Ranger, that's the latest policy. But the base was attacked a few times. And during all of those attacks, your soldier was there and present. And because you have very low bravery but very high accuracy, your soldier's a very good shot, you were doing the sniper thing, and you were doing it quite well. Alright, aggressive scouting by Malkuth. Back away. And let our commander in chief show you how it's done. First you destroy the building to your left, and then you shoot the alien in the face. Yeah, this is standard XCOM policy. Buildings first, aliens last. Superlude is gonna face tank anything that comes around that corner to save his commanding officers. He is that much of a tryhard. And our brave guy, Mr. Stank, still has the record kills in two single missions ever, I think. He's gonna face tank that corner over there. The people with live grenades, you're gonna swing wide here. But you guys will enter the UFO, because with live grenades it's pretty funny. If aliens come around the corner and kill you, they immediately get blown up. It's a nice little side effect. I'm not hearing any more doors from outside the UFO, which is good news. One came out. Pretty good. Ducky, do the reaction fire thing. Anything that steps out of this UFO dies. Unless it's one of us, of course. Alright, that group is going to clear that side. I think that's going to work out. Let's gather some more troops in here before we go in. Now this group is going to go in first, and then the groups with live grenades are going to come in. Which means if the first guys die, the guys with live grenades will follow suit and suicide bomb the hell out of the aliens. I hope you guys approve of my strategies. Oh, we see one. Alright, one down. This is always dangerous, because somehow always aliens come up here. Five Ace is going to stay down. You guys are going to be at the door. You're going to push up as soon as people die, and I suspect people will die. This place over here is always a death trap. It's nasty, it's evil and bad. I'll let the commander watch the door, at least for a bit. Nice, they're panicking. That's good news. The fact that they're panicking means they're dropping weapons and they're just basically not moving. Oh, hello, Mr. Engineer. Good night. Alright, quite happy with the fact that they panicked. That means they're gonna panic even more now we've taken out more. It's gonna snowball, hopefully. Let's make a little firing line. There's a door up here, which is very weird. This thing is made for floaters. They can come floating out of here. Trying to protect the cow, which is very important to, you know, crucial missions of the aliens. This is hopefully a medic that's carrying a stun launcher, because otherwise Malkuth might die. Navigator panicked. Good news. Yeah, it's carrying a stun launcher. Let's just whale him in the back. Now you two, you're doing great. Oh, no! Whoa! Damn it! I just said it, didn't I? You're doing great, and then they die. That's 100 delirium that's intact. That's why this mission cannot fail, as long as we bring home the bacon. It's a success. But this was quite unfortunate. Quite unfortunate indeed. I think 5 aces died, yeah. Oh, hello. I'm encountering more and more aliens without a gun, which means it's not all lost. Scruffy Samurai here with the grenade might survive, simply because aliens are dropping weapons and panicking. If he dies, Rusa will avenge him. What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? I think that alien just shot the floor a bunch of times. At least that's my guess. Step away from the crazy floater. Rusa, don't hit your teammate. Good shooting. Nice, this is a guy that dropped his weapon. Might have been the last one even. Yeah, awesome. 3 guys dead, but for a night mission, that's not bad. We killed 20 aliens, which is a heck of a lot. And we got 100 delirium out of it. Holy shit. Whew. We lost 2 flares. I think this was, Europe. We probably need to order some more flares then. We already were kind of short on flares. I think we should bring more if it's a night mission. Another one. Going for North America again. Probably going to be another night mission. First, let's fix this though. We still have plenty of reserves that we can throw away. let's see. Ruse has been doing well. He can face tank a little bit. Lyra has been face tanking quite a bit. Let's put Kalaji at the front. Super loop behind him. 10th Legion been doing alright. And then I need 3 named soldiers. You may scream your names if you need one. I have no idea who we just lost, other than 5 aces, I think, died at this base. But let's see who comes up. We have 3 soldiers that need to be named. And I'm gonna do them randomly. I'm not even gonna show you the stats. I'm gonna check it out who's died here, by the way. You can maybe figure out 1 or 2 myself. I see we're missing a Horst. ...66 firing accuracy, 10 bravery, 68 psionic strength though, there might be a future for this guy. 2 more! Sotho says I need no name, what do you mean? Is there an Alcatraz that survived here? Empty! Alright, oh wow, that's a good soldier. RT, you're in. For the first time, I think. It's cool. It leaves this somewhat mediocre soldier with high bravery. Yeah, there's another horse. We have an RT Lonston. There you go. Let's equip the boys with armor. And once again, base Europe is somewhat good to go. We are missing a power suit here, though. Let's give him a little bit of a supply. There we go. And Team Africa is currently going to intercept that UFO. We're going to lose track of it because it's going to go over the ocean. Yeah, we're going to lose it, but we're going to find it again. Interceptor 6 can go back home. There it is. These things cross the ocean in a hurry. It's going to land twice again. Hopefully we'll be there for the second time. Sweet. Sky Ranger number 3, led by Bifatu. There's a Darth in there. There's a Alcatraz Zalaz here. With pretty horrible firing accuracy. There's Skeeto still running around. We have a Meridian, who I don't think showed up tonight, sadly. We have an Olira, Ruza, Alchemist, who are all watching. Stank's watching. Scruffy, everybody's here. We even have an Eldocarina. And Mufatu is going to be... Oh, you're not going to be stepping out first. Holy shit. All these guys are going to fire into the Sky Range, aren't they? God damn. If you explain the joke, it runs... I see now. Okay. Well, that Olira person is pretty damn smart. I know he's a well-educated man. And I'm multitasking after driving my car for the entire afternoon. So, yeah, I'm not going to be very sharp. I am having a lot of fun, though, and this turns out to be one hell of a start to a mission. Mufatu, please make your shots. Wow. Well, it could have gone worse, I suppose. There were random people being hit here at the back of the Sky Ranger somehow. Alright, wow. No, I'm not gonna abort, Alcatraz. No way, I'm not gonna abort. This thing is intact. It's 100 delirium waiting for us to just pick it up. Aborting is not an option. However, Mufatu here... Wow, you just face tanked another one. Is one that can tank it and then just step aside and let others take some fire. Yeah, we're never gonna abort a mission like this. Even though we land in the middle of buildings with aliens facing our way and all that crap. No way. We are fighting for the lives of these poor farmers here, you know? The people that inhabited this area, they deserve to be protected by XCOM and have their buildings destroyed by grenades arbitrarily because we hate buildings. That's what we do. That's what these people deserve. Let's see. Let's put you on this side. Move you up a bit. Olira here, who is a doctor. He's not a medical doctor, but we're going to pretend he is. He's going to save your ass. At least somewhat. We'll fix you up next turn a little bit more. Alchemist, you know there are aliens in this building. There you go. Can you... I don't know how we're going to do this, really. I guess we're just going to run out, like we usually do. And fire? Ruza, can you please fire? Wow! That was impressive stuff. He even identified the second alien in this building. You know he's there. You just... Yeah, you know, we didn't see him. We can even put some people out of the way. No, Skeeto! I just wanted to save you and make room for other people so they can kill that alien. I don't think it was even him that shot. No, it was probably him that shot. Alright, Suvorov, can you do it again? No, you probably shouldn't either. Just step out of the way. Mr. Stank here. We'll have plenty of time in us to fire. And still step out of the way if needed. Alright. That turn could have gone worse, I suppose. Skeeto, did you just start watching the stream? Welcome to the stream, sir. Let me be the first to welcome you to this joyous occasion. What a way to enter. Alright. There's probably more in this building too. I've got nobody facing it. That's not smart. I can't face it really much. Alright, let's just see how it goes. It's gonna be... I'm gonna say two dead. It's gonna be my prognosis. I'll pour myself, oh wow, a glass of wine and cheers to the dead, but that's not neat. Yeah, I think you missed standard training, standard briefing there, Sophus. Plasma's bad for your health, okay? Plasma's bad, okay? That's just how it works. You don't face tank it voluntarily unless you do it to save your teammates. One single shot to the wall, please. Thank you. Maybe just step out. Rookie Stank here. We'll check out if all aliens are indeed dead. It looks like it. Let's get poor Mofatu patched up even further here. And you probably need a stimulant too. Keep the morale up. And of course, being banged up as you are, you've just volunteered for all the danger scouting that can possibly be done. I'm quite surprised if this is all that there is in this building. Alright, put it away. Let's go. I'm trying to read the chat in the meantime while moving my souls. It's very hard to do. Did Captain just ruin your whiskey? What did he do? Where's the bloody UFO? Isn't it like a harvester? Yeah, there it is. It should be bloody huge. For bigger UFOs, the maps are bigger too. Alright, not hearing doors of buildings. Which is all good news. And it's quite amazing news as well, I might add. Alright. Roll on. Next turn, you can go out. XCOM soldiers don't need doors. The base is actually getting littered with holes in the walls because people are just shooting holes in it with plasma. Very annoying habit. I know I've been training you guys to do it in mission, but you're not supposed to do it in base. I mean, there's like literally 7 lines to the coffee machine. With doors right next to it. It's very annoying. Horse is actually making a sport out of it. It's making horse-shaped holes in the base so you can just step through. It only fits him. Let's rush the UFO. Shots fired from the darkness. And we face tanked them like pros. Who got shot? You did. From a building, no doubt. Yep, it's another building. And yes, it holds aliens. Is there a way to just chuck a grenade on there? How strong are you? You got a strength of 40. I bet you can chuck a grenade on top of that building. You don't have a grenade. Never mind. Let's just shoot him. Scruffy. That's not shooting him at all. We have a Kilaji here. You can do an aimed one. No, you can just take down the bloody building. Nice. You even have enough time units to make a hole through the fence. Rusa has the very dangerous mission to aggressively scout out the right side of the UFO and then get to the door. He's gonna get backup though. But you've seen in the previous one, there's a door here, there's a door there. We're gonna try and get soldiers to both sides. just such a bloody long walk. And the fact that there's a building to the immediate right of that UFO is just such a bitch. Yeah, there you go. Buildings equal aliens equals death. Gotta hand it to you. That was a good shot. Aliens can chuck grenades now. We've been far along in the mission here that they can just do it. Which means we're probably clustering too much. I didn't catch that. Where was that? Not here, apparently. Oh, there. Alright. Mr. Suvorov, it's probably gonna be your cookie. Should it be your cookie? Actually, don't make it scruffy cookies. Because I need somebody else to push up further. Wow, scruffy, you're just such a poor shot. What is your firing accuracy? 52. You should have hit that thing like 3 times. Mafatu is gonna do it. Banged up like crazy here. Look at this. This man has like a firing accuracy of 9. He's got blood in his eyes. And he just nailed it. Scruffy, did you take notes? Excellent. We can peek a bit. We could actually wait them out. Play the waiting game. Oh wow, that's nice aggressive scouting, Kalaja. Beautiful. Eldukarina! Close. Don't shoot Kalaja in the back, please. Nice. Surprising amount of aimed shots are not hitting tonight. I don't know what's going on with that. Gotta say, I'm missing half the chat because I'm trying to keep the ball rolling here, but whenever I do peek on it, I see a lot of fun being had, which is good. Alright, let's roll. Because I tried to check the chat in between like turns, but then I missed the alien movement. Alright, we've entered the death trap. With 3 guys that have the most dangerous task in XCOM, which is surviving this particular area. What do you need? 20? 17? 13. Never mind. We're gonna need some replacements soon. Darth Peanut here is pretty much screwed. Especially because you can't turn your back. Oh no! No, that was unnecessary. Okay. Who's least likely to react? Well, that was a decent cleanup, I have to admit. We lost 2 perfectly good soldiers there, but it's just, you know, job has it. It's in the contract. There's nothing I can do. Sometimes you just die. Yes, Darth, you died. Welcome to the stream. Don't shoot the Illyrium. I know Illyra told me, I think it was Illyra, that Illyrium doesn't die by shooting it with plasma, but still. This is all about the Illyrium. Your lives are not worthy of you know. If we die and don't bring home Illyrium, then it's all in vain. If you die and bring home Illyrium, it's all good. It's all good. It's worth it then. Sorry, Darth. Shoot him, shoot him, shoot him, shoot him, shoot him, shoot him! No, Alchemist! I put you guys here so you can react, so you can kill him. So you can shoot him in the face. Why is there no line of fire? Because there's a bloody cow's head. Come on. It's never stopped us before. We're not gonna stop shooting because there's a cow in the way. That's nuts. Nice. Cool. That fits perfectly. Apparently there's still more though. You just don't see it. That was unfortunate. He was hiding in the other room. Arrgh, I hate these guys. Will you just die, please? And it's not even it. There's more. Where the bloody hell is there even more? When does this end? When does the rooting stop? When do people stop dying? When is it enough? Even the cow died, dammit. Oh shit, 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 he's in the building. Stop, stop, no. Wow, you're not even touched. Holy shit. That was too close for comfort. Five died. But it's intact. It's more Illyrium to be converted into power suits at Base Africa. And it also means that we have five open spots for new guys here that can enter the rotation. Actually six, because we have also somebody wounded as well. And the highest ranking officer here is Scruffy. He had an abysmal performance in the previous mission, but it will you know, you'll be leading the bunch on morale and charisma. Yeah, that's it, charisma. Seem to be lacking in power suits. We'll try and fix it. We're building power suits right here. This is where you start screaming, guys. I have five people. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, six people in need of names. If you're wounded, you're shit out of luck. I got 34 viewers. So we're definitely going to need people. Lonestone, you're in. You're wounded, sadly, but it's only 5 days. So let's see. Kastler is not in this particular base. No, you're going to get the first one. Oh, wow. That's a good one. And then we have a Snakey. Snakey's not at this base. Snakey's got a soldier here. And Meridian's also here. Yeah, even on board. But I can put Snakey on board, I suppose. There we go. Which brings me back to our third one. Oh wow, look at this guy. 60 bravery, 57, 63, 34 strength. Wow. The guy who has to go in a hurry will get another one. And at least one last guy, and I suppose it's gonna be Alchemist from the look at the chat. There we go. That fills up this one again. And we still need more power suits. I actually have 30 workshop space available. If you're gonna do power suits here, I can order some more engineers. Or should I stick to 100? Yeah, we're probably gonna build Avengers as well, right? 12 days until the next one is done. See you later, Lone Stone. Thanks for dropping by, man. Hopefully you can stay for one more mission. In that case, I should get a move on. There's nothing pressing going on. Let's just quickly check the research. Blaster bombs. Manufacturing stuff. Both our Sky Rangers are done? No. No, no, no. Base Africa only has... Oh, Mafatu can go back. Only has 13 people on, right? Oh, this is main... Sothers. There we go. Alright, let's get cracking. Let's get Clazier on another mission. Go to this one. We get the flares in real quick. That's the grenades. There we go. Let's do like 26 flares. There we go! They're gonna pick up a cow in force. You want one more mission, sir? You have it. This thing will land. Probably land twice. Let's do the team that's power suited up. I think that's that main, right? I think this is where we... Hang on a sec. Go back home. I want to check the power suits real quick. Yeah, there you go. Good thing I did. Sky Ranger 2 is refueling. This guy's also refueling. We'll see who gets it. It's very large. It doesn't really pay off to send any interceptors after it. Let's hope it takes a while to find the proper cow. Yeah, I'm probably going to play a little bit of MechWarrior, Kilaja. It's found a proper cow. It's only needing... yeah, it only needs one cow. Damn it! Alright, get back. Another one. That's probably the same one. Yeah. That's a shame. I would have loved to prevent them from picking up that cow. Very small sectoid alien retaliation. This one's going for Southeast Asia. Let's see what route it takes. The long one. This should be a cookie for Charlie, really. Probably need to chase it for a bit, but there you go. It's only very small. Large one, Terra ship, going for somewhere in Asia. I know, Charlie, you just landed, but you might want to need another cookie the same evening. We're going to shoot it down and play it in the morning. It is sectoids, guys. That means cyberdisc, that means psionic aliens. It means the whole shebang. It also means they just buggered off without doing bugger all. Why the hell? What's going on? It's weird. Alrighty. Psionic training. Let's start at the bottom. Anything with 50, I suppose, is worth it. Alright. This is psionic training, guys. The people that eventually get a breakthrough in this, meaning that you get skill improvements, will be able to use psioms to control the minds of aliens, or make them panic and have some fun with them. Ah, the rest is really crappy here. But the training takes up to 30 days for the first breakthrough, and after that, improvement is very slow. Unless you get training in the field as well. Training in the field is extensive, it takes a lot of time, takes a lot of doing. It also is quite a bit of a risk, because at the first couple of missions you just waste time units trying. And even field tries improve your strength, sorry, your skill. But it means you have less effective soldiers to work the missions with. until they start getting good. That's when the fun really starts. Then when you, that's when you really mind control anything you see and have them shoot each other. Alright. Blaster bombs are done. Right at the same time psionic aliens are showing up again, we can actually use blaster launches. I'm not sure if I really want to at this point without having proper psi soldiers to combine it with. It is good and fun to take out buildings with psionic, but with blaster launch though. I probably should bring one blaster launch on each Sky Ranger and only equip it when I know it's not sectoids. Let's see, flying suits are a hell of a lot of fun. One blaster launcher with 7 bombs for each of the Sky Ranges. Oh wait, there's no blaster launcher here yet in Africa? We'll transfer one. Lots of buildings done. Yeah, this thing makes the biggest boom in the game. Alien retaliation going for North Africa. Our newest Avenger is where? All Avengers are stationed in the Africa sides. Let's see. Don't go that way. Go this way. I don't want the base to be either found or attacked, so I'm going to try and prevent whatever these bloody snake men are trying to do. Probably going to plunge that thing down in the jungle and then clean them up. I'm going to save the game real brief because it's been a while. There it is. We pick it up just in time. It's going straight for us, isn't it? It's slightly off course. Let's see if we can get it over the desert. Yes, we can. Oh, there we go. Fusion missiles do the biggest boom. Well, that's on an interceptor craft, right? No, actually, I'm pretty sure the blaster launcher tank gives an even bigger boom. Before I forget, actually, the people in Africa should get their power suits. I'm very liable to forget. You all know this. There you go. I'm gonna wait until daylight. And then the people with, well, actually the best equipment and stuff going on can try and do this. Let's see who gets the blaster launcher here. Somebody's already took it. Lonstone fancies himself able to handle a blaster launcher. You got psionic strength of 7, which makes you a little bit of a potato head. I'm gonna indulge you for now. Actually, no, I'm not, because you just you had to go. I'm gonna give it to somebody who's watching. And also probably to somebody with a bit of a more psionic strength going on than 8. Actually, this might be a good job for the commander. This might be perfect because you're very strong. You can carry around all that ammunition. And you're used to hanging at the back a bit. There we go. You can carry all the blaster ammunition, really, if need be. Bruiser, put down the flare, please. Kalaji, come on, stop being an idiot. Great place to land. Absolutely awesome place to land. We What do you mean you don't believe in Psy? You don't get Psy, you get the big boom, you get the blaster launcher. Mr. Duckerino, you get the biggest gun in the game in your hands. Nothing to do with psionic strength. It has to do with the fact that you're strong enough to carry it around. But yeah, it also, I think you'd be a good candidate to do it permanently because you got 50 psionic strength. I actually should check if you're in training or not. There's a whole formula behind it that put the flare down. If you're being mind controlled or you're mind controlling somebody, it's a combination of strength and skill combined with distance between the guy that's being mind controlled and the person that's doing it. Which means with a strength of 50, you'll never be great, but you should build up some resistance to it. You are in training, thank you. Very good of you to keep track of stuff that I don't. Good luck, man. Is this the craft with RT in it? I'll check a sec. Yeah, the Hovertank has 8-round magazine, but it does have the biggest boom in the game. Even more impressive than the blaster launcher. Where are these aliens? A pretty crap shot. Better. Continue the aggressive scouting, Lum. We all know standard procedures for these very large is without psionic aliens in them. That was good. Some will circle around, eventually we'll all set up a firing line and we'll select two brave guys. It might even be Jay Stank again, he's done this before, he's got experience in how this works. A couple of brave guys will walk up to the central door, there's only one door to this entire UFO. And they'll start peeking, but I think we only should start peeking after a couple of turns waiting, because there's still lots of chrysalids around. Okay, you got the high ground, it's not really needed, but hopefully it prevents you from hitting anything you don't want to. Yeah, this is with RT, cool. Come on. You're gonna see some action in this one. Yeah, it's chrysalids again, Mr. Galadia. This is nasty. But somehow they don't come out, they're like afraid to play. They don't want to come out and play with us. It's very unsportsmanlike of them. Horst is in position. Scruffy's in position. And Suvorov, you're the firing line to the right. And O'Leary here is going to be the volunteer to peek the doors. The rest will circle around. This group will push on even further and start peeking from this side. Should be a delegation of 4, I think. Artie's gonna follow them. And another delegation will follow these guys and will be the firing line. And I think Super Elu here is gonna be our second guy to peek, or should it be Jay Stank? No. I haven't decided yet. I know Stank's got the experience, but at the same time, I'm kinda liking the guy. Meridian says volunteer. Where are you currently located, sir? Are you with us? That's everybody. Chrysalid spotted. Since Chrysalid acts they're technically female. Yeah, that might be the case, but I'll still pass on that. Actually, this is very dangerous what I'm doing right now. I know there's a Chrysalid here. I can blow it up, but it might blow up Illyrium as well. And we all know Illyrium is like the juice of the gods, so we'll not do that. Although I suppose I could do it like at a distance, like over here. Or maybe over here. Will that blow up any Illyrium if I put a blaster bomb here? Like right over there? Will that kill any Illyrium? It probably will kill the Chrysalid. Or it might not. You want to do it again, J-Stank? You want to be the guy peeking? Somebody's got to do it. Two somebody's actually got to do it. Okay, reload next turn. J-Stank says, let's do this. Alright. That is the spirit. We got some backup from that side coming in. And hopefully this will somehow work out. Oh, nice. Let's hope he crosses this line here, because, yeah. Not ideal. But we have a lot of people that can react. Lonestone is probably in need of some support down here. With probably, I say definitely. Alright, good luck, gentlemen. Shoot him, shoot him, shoot him, shoot him, shoot him. There he comes. Shoot him. These things are so bad for my nerves. Nice. Thank you, gentlemen. You're in position. Olira's in position. J-Stank is in peaking position as well. We still need to establish the firing line to this side. It will take a turn to set up. Now those things like everybody. That's the problem with them. And Erty can back up the peakers, I think. Yeah. Alright. Yeah, maybe the blaster bomb indeed kind of knocked it out of its comfort zone. Jay's tank has started the peeking. Killed the snake man. Alira finds nothing. That's your backup. Alright. There we go. Everybody's in position. Let's start the peeking. This is just going to be looking, backing off, maybe taking a shot here and there if you find something and repeating. And hoping that when chrysalids do come out, they'll get immediately fired upon by our firing squads, because we have people that can be zombified real close to these exits. I want to clone your Darth, but I love the fact that I have like 30 viewers going on. It's kind of hard to get you in. Also, I have to admit, I think I'm playing rather cautiously. Very unlike what I usually do. Which means not a lot of people are dying. At least not as many as we're used to. We'll work on it, Mr. Stank. Damn, Sothis, you know a lot of details on chrysalids. Does your clone have a specific obsession, maybe? I think there was a reaction shot involved there, but you at least killed one. Yeah, these are luring shots indeed. Oh, I should rearm your gun. You never know when it's needed. Also get a little bit closer. I could actually open the door and fire a blaster bomb in there. But that is very risky business. As you've seen in the Let's Play probably, they tend to explode in your face sometimes. Yeah, there's no line of fire to be had. I mean, I can blow up the top floor and stuff like that with the blaster launcher, but it might actually ruin a lot of stuff that we can salvage. It's a gamble. And if the thing actually blows up in the elevator shaft, it will kill all the XCOM soldiers around it. I don't think that's something Ducky wants on his conscience, so we'll refrain from doing it. And I think you killed it, Mr. Stank. Let's hope it was not a chrysalid. What do you see? No way you could shoot it. How can you see it? Let's hope it is not able to shoot you. That's an impressive angle, and apparently you once again evaded a reaction shot that came your way. I think they might start panicking soon. Somehow they're able to shoot through the floor at that particular area. That's dangerous too. They can even send a blaster bomb through if they're clever. Stop it! I don't know how there's a hole in the floor there. What the hell? Wow, Alira. You need medical attention, man. Unlucky. Very unlucky. You hit it twice. That's all you can do. And Alira needs help. We can blow up the top floor, I suppose. What do you say, Ducky? You want to give it a shot? This is not a safe place. Ducky, I'll leave it up to you, man. You want to make the shot? I can lay out the waypoints already. It'll be something like this. Then we go down, past these men, go in here, take to the center, go straight up, and then hit the alien. You got that? Alright. Oh, good call, sir. Very good call. That will panic them for sure. We just blew up like all of their officers, I think. Very nice. Very good carnage. Let's get you some help. Let's reinforce. Let's capitalize on the fact that we just took out a bunch of them. Might be dangerous though. It's probably still a chrysalid or two around. See if Jace Tank's got lucky. He's got a target in front of him if he does. Yeah, I think he did. Good shooting, man. Very good shooting. How are you not the commander of this operation? All respect to Ducky, though. We just nailed a bunch of the aliens. Oh, there was a deep fall. Let's hope he didn't blow up all the axes to, like, this floor. Okay, no, he didn't. Nice. This might be another commander. It had a gun in hand still, so it wasn't one of the panicky ones. Can we... I think we fall through here if we do. Yeah, we do. Alright. No biggie. I'm gonna get some guys in here. Navigate the panic, leader panicked. Yeah, we got this. Ducky actually made a good call there. It's always dangerous, but... I love that he played that risky. Of course he knew it would never hit him. With every alien we kill now, they're gonna freak out even more. Oh wow, we do need to actually kill some people, guys. Come on. Shit. Damn, how are we gonna do this? This guy's gonna walk around, he's gonna go in front of Horst, and maybe Horst can kill him. We still have to reload you, don't we? Yeah, you can't do it this turn. You might be able to take care of business next turn, but not this one. Damn it. Yeah, I think that's Rip Arty as well. Probably. I like how everybody's typing it in as a gesture of good faith to the man. Good luck, man. Horst, shoot him! Horst, shoot him! Oh, there's two! There's two of them! Horst, no! There's three of them! Four of them! Jesus. Yeah, you just take yourself with the nurses while I have a heart attack, Horst. Why don't you just go right ahead? This is dangerous. I should not do this. And there's one over there as well. I should just form firing lines or stuff like that. Yeah, because they need a long way to go. That's probably the better idea at the moment. Or maybe even just blow everything up. If this doesn't work. Horst, get out. Get out, get out, get out. Enough time units. Not playing this right. Playing this too fast, not thinking it through. I'm doing the bunny thing again, where people die. This is not the way to go. I was doing pretty well up until this point. I've no idea how long I've been streaming for, but I'm quite happy with the way I played up until this point. And now I'm not handling this situation very calmly. Actually, you could say I'm just blindly panicking. Alright, I forgot the top floor. That's very bad. Yeah, you guys start laughing. I actually hated the fact that I forgot the top floor. Also, Horse, you should probably just back off at this point and let the boys handle it with reaction fire. We know there's another one coming. Where is it? Ah! Down there! Alright. That might be fixable by blaster launcher stuff. Yeah, that'll be doable. Fire it straight away from the wall. Over there. Over there. Fire it inside. Let it go straight up. Fire here. Fire through this. Into his face. Good shot, Ducky. Now we know he's down below there. We might need the second shot. We actually see him. Cool. Alright, good one, Horst. Nice. No! Yeah, that's a bit too late on the reaction fire, guys. Jesus. Whew. 15 minutes ago, yeah, I might not bring blaster launchers. Well, if I bring them, you know, I just go nuts. 3 dead is not too bad, though. We killed 23 bloody aliens, and 2 of them were once our soldiers, I suppose. We lost a medkit. Jace Tank made it the captain, which is rather impressive. And that, wow, I need a break after that one. Holy shit. Was that the Africa squad? No, it was definitely the Euro squad. Mufato can get back in, and we need 3 more. Oh, damn it. Put the high ranking guys in front, that's not good. Yeah, nicely sorted by rank. Let's give them armor and then give them a name. This is where you start shouting in chat, guys. If you want a soldier and you're not already on this particular Sky Ranger or somewhere wounded, this is your chance to be on it. This is your shot at glory, at immortality. See you, Klazirunen. Thanks for sticking around, man. Yeah, if you're not, if you haven't slept, this is definitely the time. Now, I know I'm showing you an awful soldier. 44 firing accuracy, bravery 10. Yeah, there's no more nurses, Mufato. You're back in business. It's back to the gym, and back to facing aliens in the wild. I think this universe corrected itself. Because there's only 1 5 aces left here. That's right, Meridian. If you're here now, that's what counts. Doesn't matter if you need to go in 20 minutes. Another one! And this is a good one. This is a really good one. Ah yeah, 10th Legion. You had a good good run with your first one. That leaves one soldier to go. See ya, Addy. Thanks for stopping by, man. Snakey says I want to die. That can be arranged. I think he used to be a baseball player. 74 throwing accuracy is pretty insane. Not used much though, but can come in handy. I suppose with some dead guys around, I should also see if there's openings up in psionic training. And I guess slowly but steadily we might have enough power suits to actually supply our Avenger. Actually not by a long shot. We'll just continue to churn them out. Our Avenger will come into play when we really need it, I suppose. Alright guys, I'll have a short bathroom break, because I do need a little break after this one. Short breather. 2 minutes. And then I'll be right back. I hope you guys enjoy yourself in the chat. And I'll catch you in a minute. I don't have any fancy waiting screen, so I'll leave you on this. Yeah, there should be a red shirt mob. That would be pretty cool. Alright, let's keep on trucking for a little bit. I have no idea what the time is, but I don't feel like quitting just yet. And neither do the aliens. Wow. The last one didn't land. The last one looked around and left. It is sectoids, which means no blaster launcher will be equipped. Shoot it down. I don't think even our commander is ready to equip a blaster launcher. You were in training, you said. Yeah, you are. Alright. Already 206? Holy shit! I kinda clicked on it randomly, but I did not expect that. Alright. Now this will be funny. Ducky, no more blaster bombs for you. Leave it by the door, please. And one clip will have to do. Oh yeah, this thing has cyber discs. Which is bad news, because these things kill stuff in one hit. As demonstrated right here. Meridian, you had a soldier, but you needed to go in 10 minutes? I think I found a solution. Thank you. This is good. If we kill the Sabotage, we kill the sector next to it too. Yeah, that's a bit much. That was a bit too much to take. Ruzo, be very careful, man. Wow, how did he took 3 plasma hits and lived? Nice, that's 2 kills for you. And apparently the guys that were reacting are out of shots. It's been snaky here. It's up to you. Yep, nice. Let's finish him up. Alright. Aggressive scouting initiated. Aimed, maybe? No line of fire. You do see him. I mean, Kalaji had a shot from over there, so... What's your problem? Seriously? Kalaji can't move anymore, he's like rooted to the spot. Whoa! Shame you're not watching anymore, Lone Star. You should have seen the shot you saw you just made. That was pretty nice. Yeah, you get credit. You get credit for 2 kills when you do it like that. Softwares, don't be so negative. You do get credit. You shoot the cyber disk and it explodes and it takes a bunch of aliens with it. You do get credit for killing all of them. I have checked it in the past. So it begins. Of course we're running around with all potato hats here because, you know, I left the Psy soldiers all in training. We all know that this might end horribly bad. Scruffy. That's not great. That side of this might react, so let's stick to this side. How come you see? Oh, wow, you see one over there. That's quite a find. Can you watch your aim a little bit? You nearly shot Jay Stank there. Ruzo seems to be a good shot. That's a difficult one here. Wow, that was all over the place. Maybe this is easier? Bit of a better angle? Fine, that's good. That's nice. Impressive. I gotta hand it to you. You hit 2 out of 3. It didn't even react. Which means Lonestar might be able to finish it here. If you didn't have potato aim. Well, you hit it once, at least. It seems to be the evening of Kalaja. I know you're not being negative. I'm just saying. Basically, I'm just talking and words are coming out of my mouth. Half the time, I don't even know what I'm saying. Commander at risk. And everybody's at risk constantly from each other as well, because you know you're gonna get mind control and just blast the guy next to you. Or this will happen. Comrade Suvorov had a good run. Ow, 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 ow. Cyber disks hurt like crazy. Come on, Malkuth. Seen you do a lot better than this. potato aim Blundstone. Alright, that took out of a sectoid as well. And there should be another one here somewhere. Great. We don't find it with our usual aggressive scouting. Oh, now we do. Aimed shot, please. Aimed, but no cigar. Better. Mr. Stank. Always a killer. That one didn't die, but that's no biggie. We can move some stuff around now. Commander gets over there. Actually, you guys can go on that side and probably clear it. I don't know how Stank's ability is to withstand psionic stuff. 31 only. It's 74 for Scruffy, though. So, Stank here is the only risk. In fact, Bruiser can reinforce with 50 as well. Should be a decent group. The rest, bugger off and leave the commander alone, please. And then there's poor Kalaja. Bleeding from his ears. We'll patch him up though. Another one of these bloody cyberdiscs. We patch him up as soon as we find a medkit. Guys? Yeah. There we go, we share the wealth here at XCOM. Also, we see the cyberdisc, which is good. Snakey, let's make you famous. That was pretty good. That's 2 out of 3. It's one with a stun launcher. Not a real biggie. It's the cyberdisc that's still roaming around here somewhere that has me worried. Alright, Scruffy, that was pretty good. Credit where credit's due, that was pretty good. Now let's set up a bit of a firing line here. Now let's keep running to the other side of the UFO here. Maybe that cyberdisc that came out of this side was the one that was actually in the middle, which means there's no more cyberdisc. That would be good news. That's a bit of wishful thinking, though.